shoulder sideways, smack it in the air. Legs move it side to side, smack it in the air. Legs move it side to side, smack it in the air. Shoulder sideways, smack it in the air. Smack it in the air. Legs move it side to side, smack it in the air. Smack it in the air.
Alright guys, so welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to be doing a get ready with me. Makeup, an outfit, my hair is already did. You already know when you see a bun, you already know what the business is. I'm going to try to talk to y'all through this video. I don't know if I'm gonna do this again. No, but I hate voiceovers. I hate doing voiceovers when it comes to like doing makeup. So I'm gonna try to like talk to y'all in more videos while I'm doing makeup, because I feel like that's a little bit more interactive. If you wanna know how I did this look, then just keep watching. All right, y'all, so I did this eye already. So I'm gonna attempt to talk to you guys while I do my makeup. This is so weird. I feel like there's so much going on right now. So what I'm gonna do is prime my eyes. I'm not gonna use primer. I'm just gonna go in with my Studio Fix foundation in NC45. So I'm gonna take a 217 brush. I should have told you what this brush was. I think this is like the eyeshadow brush or whatever, whatever. I'm gonna go into raise and blush, okay? So I'm just gonna go into my crease, but make sure I concentrate it. I'm literally like dab. When it comes to, you know, your crease color and like blending and stuff, you really wanna start small, you know? You don't wanna go hard and go home type thing, because you're gonna have to go home by using makeup remover. And then I'm not adding anything to the brush, I'm just blending it upward, just like that. Then I'm gonna take a 224 brush if I can find it. And then I'm gonna go in with saddle. Now I'm going to take a 242 brush by MAC, and then I'm gonna go in, carve out my lid. I feel like I have a really small lid, so you see I made it a little bigger, like a smudge. So I'm just going to draw it out. Once I got the desired shape, I'm going to go in with soft brown and then just pack it on there. I'm gonna lightly blend the edges on the inner corner right here, like this half. I'm just blending it just a little. And then I'm gonna go in with a blending brush and just kind of smooth out those edges right there. Then I'm gonna go in with a pencil brush, aka the 219 brush by MAC. And then, I don't know, I started off a little light. I started off a little light with Soot. Funny name, Soot by MAC. So, and then I ended up going in with Carbon, but whatever, I'm gonna do exactly what I did on that side. What you wanna do is like really keep this concentrated, like really, really open. And then I'm gonna go in with Carbon. So I'm gonna take a 266 brush by MAC. This is the L'Oreal Infallible gel liner. So it's in black. So I really like it, guys. I don't know, I'm weird. This is just my flow. I like to start right up. And then work my way that away. So I like to draw the line first up here, and then like, do you see how I'm making literally, I'm gonna bring it a little under. Do you see how I'm taking like the smallest strokes? And then you see I'm gonna flip my brush this way. And connect. I'm gonna go back in with my pencil brush. I'm not really gonna add anything because there's already quite a bit. So I'm just gonna smoke out the lash line and then I'm gonna go in just like a dab of raisin. Go under there. The falsies. I've never tried this, but I mean, I've heard so many good things about it. Like, look at this brush. This brush is beautiful. Y'all know how I feel about this with the bottom lash, because I don't know, I guess I'm so used to either Extended Play by MAC or the Studio Sculpt, because those are really small brushes. Like, I got little lashes and this is really getting the job done. I'm sure if I just wanted to focus on lashes, I can like pack this on. So I really do like that factor. Duh, I almost forgot. I'm just gonna go in with rice paper, just a little bit. And then I got that Physician Formula, what is this called? Shimmer strip? I don't know, it's just not giving me the life that I desire. Like, maybe I need to use it wet, but I feel like as a highlighter, you shouldn't have to, I shouldn't have to wet it for it to be like popping. Not really a fan. But I mean, I'm gonna use it because I bought it. But I got the 35s, and then stacked on top of them is the 43s, both by MAC. I kind of just like, I don't know. I like how they look. All right, I'm gonna prime and moisturize my face. So I'm gonna use strobe cream, my all-time favorite. Look, I just love strobe cream. It just gives me so much life. Sometimes I just like wearing this. And then Natural Radiance Primer, also by MAC. My sister recently tried Porefessionals. I forgot what is it Benefits? I think it's Benefits, Porefessionals. And she said she loves it. So I think I'm gonna try that. I think I'm gonna try that, guys. So for my foundation, I'm not using Studio Fix today. You're gonna be like, what? You're not using Studio Fix? I went to Sephora and I heard a lot of good things about the Marc Jacobs Remarkable foundation. So I grabbed that. All right, it's a $48 foundation. So I grabbed a sample. I'll grab the sample because what if I don't like it? You know, it's like $48 and I'm not, like, no. There's some things that I will use up even though I'm like not a fan, but foundation isn't one of them. Like, if I really don't like it, like I'm not using it. Why is this so messy? Why is it so hard to open? God, I can't take it. So I'm just gonna put it all on my face. It smells like paint, but like a different kind of paint. People say Studio Fix smells like paint. I love the smell. Wipe it off my hand. And then I'm just, I think this is in Coco Light. Y'all, first of all, I feel like I used a lot. I hope it doesn't oxidize because it's gonna be too dark. Go ahead, Marc Jacobs. I don't know how I like that color. All right, don't judge a book. All right, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna balance out the color. I feel like it's oxidizing. This looks, y'all, if you like cake, sometimes, in this occasion, I like cake. When I'm out, when I'm going out with my girls, when I'm going out, I like it cakey. Okay, y'all, listen, so, totally ran out of memory and I just I feel like I have to get this done in 6 minutes. Yeah, I blended it out, so I don't even feel like I need to set anything. Like, this looks so good just like this. Like, I don't feel like I need to set anything. I promise to God, I feel like I'd be setting my stuff just to be extra. And then I'm just gonna go in with Uninterrupted. Y'all know what's my fave. After doing that, I'm just gonna go back in with raisin. concentrated on the apples of my cheeks and then blend it back. You'll learn that I'm not really, I mean, I'm a blush fan, but I'm not gonna blush it up, you know what I mean? I'm not going to go super crazy. And then what I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna do it like that. Have it on one side. And cut it right out. Just lined up. And then of course, this face is mandatory. A little bit. Just a little bit. Just wanna, I can't help it. I have elephants upstairs. So I'm gonna be going in with Ulta's matte cream lip steering. I don't have time. Lying, y'all. I just want it a little bit more matte. Just a smidge. Is I'm gonna set it with a little bit of translucent powder. So let me get dressed, okay? Because I can't wear this to the club. I mean, I could, but people be looking at me like, I think she's forgetting something. This ain't a slumber party. I hope this inspired you to get out with your ladies and have some fun. And I will see you guys in the next video.